It did, Sean, taxing both men and equipment. Now, as you take a live look at the scene where you see that charred rubble on the ground there, that's about where fire officials believe this fire started. One tenant who didn't want to go on camera said that fire seemed to spread almost instantaneously. 10 hours after the fire at Davis Place was first reported, firefighters removed the body of the one tenant who didn't make it out.
Just devastated. I don't know what to think or...
The man lived in one of the center units of the six-unit apartment building. Lane says he will be sorely missed.
He pretty much took care of me at one point in time, and I don't know what I'm going to do without him.
Around 10:45 Tuesday night, a tenant reported flames coming from a back porch. The fire chief says the first units immediately struck a second alarm.
They actually had in the back of the building a fire in two separate apartments going up the back of the building on two floors.
The chief says firefighters evacuated some tenants but were unable to get to the victim. One firefighter trying to enter the room suffered second-degree burns when the room flashed over. After 40 minutes, all firefighters were ordered out.
Subsequently now, the second floor and the roof's burned away and the second floor is caved in several places.
With temperatures in the single digits, the bitter cold also caused problems.
We got hoses freezing to the ground, nozzles freezing if you shut them off. Guys are in there working and they get wet and they instantly freeze solid. So we've been rotating the crews in and out since we got here.
It took 60 firefighters about 2 hours to get the fire under control, but the chief says it did so much damage, the building will probably have to come down. The name of the victim is being withheld until relatives have been notified. As for how this fire started, when the chief says there was so much damage done that they may never know. Reporting live in Laconia, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.